Get better performance out of your Behringer Euphoria USB audio interface. I'm going to show you how to install the Behringer UMC22 driver in this video. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where we do tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, including more USB audio interface tips and tutorials, please subscribe to the channel. I'm Radio Zane, and in this video, we're going to be going over step-by-step the Behringer UMC22 driver setup in Windows 10. Plus, stick around to near the end, as I have an important tip that you should know before recording with it. You should also note that this driver should work on Windows 7 and 8. I just have Windows 10 on this system, so that's what I'm showing you on. So let's jump in. First, download the driver from the link. You'll then want to extract the zip file. Go into the folder, then go into this folder and double click on the setup. Choose your language here, click OK, then click Install Driver. It will ask you to plug in your audio interface if you don't have it plugged in already. Do that now and it will complete the installation. Now it's going to tell you that you need to reboot your computer for it to work. So go ahead and do that. Alright, so I've restarted my computer, and now what we want to do is set it up in your DAW and access the control panel. For this video, I'm using the great free DAW, Tracktion T7. I have a playlist of videos about Tracktion T7 if you're interested. I'll link to them in the description and you can check those out later. But you don't need Tracktion T7 to do this. You should be able to do this within most DAWs. You just want to go to your settings and your audio devices. You want to make sure that the device type or driver type is set to ASIO. Then you want to make sure that the Behringer USB audio is selected, as it is here. And then you can go to Control Panel, and this brings up the Behringer USB driver control panel. And from here, click on ASIO, and you'll now see that we have a System Performance tab here. This is where you change the latency. Now, you may say, well, why don't I just choose the highest speed one? Well, that's because your audio interface and your computer may not be able to handle the highest speed. What you want to do is find that happy medium between system performance and latency. So I suggest trying fast, see how that is. If it works, go up to the next one and the next one until you figure out which one works best for you. Now, if you have a project that's full of tracks and MIDI instruments and all kinds of things, you may start to notice some pops and clicks. So what you'll want to do is relax it a bit. And you can go down here. As long as everything's already recorded and you're just doing some editing and mastering, it shouldn't really matter that you've set it to relax. Just experiment with what works best for you. And when you're ready, you click close, and now you can go record something. If you'd like to see how to get zero latency in Tracktion T7 without installing anything extra or any additional hardware, I actually did a video on that and I'll link to that in the description below. The Behringer UMC22 USB audio interface is a decent budget-priced audio interface. In this price range, you won't find anything better, and this driver takes it up a notch, just a bit. If you're using this for YouTube videos, streaming, or recording music, you should be happy with the quality and the price. Which brings me to a question for you. What type of content will you be creating with this audio interface? Let me know in the comments below. And now for that important tip that I told you about. When you install this driver, you need to make sure that you record or stream to a mono track. That's because a guitar cable or a mic cable is a mono source. If you try to record or stream into a stereo track, you may get just the left side only. I've done a couple of videos on how to do this in OBS Studio and in Audacity. It's very easy to do. I'll link to those videos in the description so you can check them out. Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to see more audio tips, tutorials, and reviews from us, including more videos on using the Behringer UMC22, please subscribe to the channel. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.